So, good afternoon. I'll be talking more about satellites. Okay. So, a little bit of my background. I'm actually from the financial technology background. So, I spent some 17 years in Goldman Sachs, more on the trading side of things. So, what satellites as a platform are becoming more prevalent. And they used to be there, they have been there for, you know, decades, but now they are becoming more available from a commercial application point of view. And more people can start using these for decisions in your day-to-day life, in business and whatnot. The image that you see up there is actually a composite that shows light at night. So what do you use this for? It's being used for economic tracking, activity modeling. It is being used for identifying zones of poverty and so on and so forth. The company is a startup. We are roughly 3 years old. Majority of the team actually comes from ISRO. So here goes. So what can you do with satellites? Every day you use satellites for three things. Communication, location, as well as observation. And at home, communication, you're getting satellite TV. Location, you're getting the GPS on your phone. And then observation is what I'll talk about. Essentially, today what's happening is, and that's what we do, we take satellite data and the financial advances around this, AI, big data, and start answering questions across multiple domains on what's there, where is it, when will it be there, the risk, et cetera, et cetera. Okay? And we are actually, this may look like a technical equation, it's also financial, because the financial advances across all three are actually making it commercially viable to deliver. And when I say commercial advances, let's take a look at this satellite, right? The one on the left, which was some 13 or 14 years back, and the one on the right do exactly the same thing. Okay, they image the Earth at between 2.5 to 3 meters, but the one on the left cost more than $50 million to build and launch. You can correct me if I'm wrong, but you know. But one on the right is build and launch at below $200,000 to $300,000. So why that's happening is because when you launch something in space, it needs to be robust, it needs to be weight efficient, it needs to be energy efficient. And cell phones are driving this. So that's what's happening over there. And we are leveraging these advances to actually use this platform to deliver across multiple platforms. An example, capabilities. Any idea what this building is? Taj Mahal, right? So, can you see people in this picture? No. You see some spots on the white area to the north? That's people. That's the capability that, you know, satellites bring today. You can actually see something as small as that. Okay? Another, this is Kennedy Space Center. Okay? But you can see the Saturn V that took people to the moon. And you can also see the space shuttle booster, but that's okay, you can see. There's a huge amount of data in this picture for us. How many buildings, how many cars, how much road, what is the water surface, et cetera, et cetera. This becomes data. And when you're starting to use AI, deep learning, this data starts evolving to actually make daily decisions possible. We talked about this, right? Solar rooftop. You can use this we are looking at use cases for solar rooftop deployment, for urban gardens, on rooftop gardens. Or this is not only from a deployment point of view, but also from a financing point of view. So where do you lend money to? And from a market assessment, Second one, the building height tracking. Multiple use cases from lending to regulatory, to even things like airports on the approach path, are the buildings actually breaching the safe limit or not? So are they adding risk to the city? Okay. That goes into how do you actually start using this data? Okay, so here's an example of urban analytics where the use case was figuring out parking, financial viability of a parking solution. So where is the traffic? What is, how, over a period of time, where the traffic is more, what the building size is, what's drawing the parking, and then build a model on top of it. So satellites, because you can capture this data every day or over a particular, you know, rapid frequency, you can actually start solving these problems very cost effectively in getting the data which may not be available. Two, road network mapping. To quality of road network. You know, especially as India grows and urban cities, what was tier two, tier four, tier five start becoming more and more urban centers, the platform, satellites become a much greater platform to be able to doing things much more effectively, maybe not with the same precision, but from a decision point of view, they will help achieve things much faster. Two, flood risk analysis, we talked about it. Okay, so either from the use cases I get are not from a mapping point of view, not people who are actually looking at it from a asset owner. There are so many other people who may need the same information who may not be asset owners in banking, in finance, in insurance, or even in siting assets. So if somebody is putting up a factory or a warehouse, are they in the right place or the wrong place? So this helps you get those answers rather quickly for what may not be visible otherwise. This platform helps you achieve that. An example is flood response, Kerala floods. Okay, we were actually asked to help the government. We turned it around in 3 days to actually identify where inundation is occurring. So the top left is actually what happened to Kochi Airport underwater. Okay, it was actual inundation. Two, you can see the roads going underwater. But the second, the one on the bottom is actually now bringing location data from cell phones and, you know, to where people were asking for rescues. And the government actually used this, what we, anecdotal evidence, what they told us was they used the system and the data that was being projected to help somewhere around 15 to 17,000 rescues. And the way they saw this data, they put people to say, okay, here's your sector, look at what the data is saying, direct people over there. That is the way they actually used it in a very, very quick response. Where that has actually gone to on the right is actually a risk mapping on a PIN code level. So the same data can be used multiple times for multiple consumers and help this. Now, one of the big things that we are doing is actually financial engineering of the solution. How do we actually make this, the cost of this, and by multiple reuse so that multiple people are able to use it, so the cost becomes low, less, and more people are able to use it. Okay. Of course, surveillance. We talked about it, multiple use cases, encroachment to property tax. And I know stories about in Greece, swimming pools being detected and measured, compared against income tax returns to find out people who have not paid. Okay. Slightly interesting use case. I have time, yeah. So this was very interesting. So Hawaii, I digress, but it's interesting. Hawaii, it's a very lush green place. Some people brought goats over there. Okay, the goats ran away and they became wild and started eating up. Now they wanted to find where the goats are. Now, if you look at Hawaii, these are islands and whatnot. So what they did, they picked a bunch of goats, they put GPS trackers on them, let them loose, and as the vegetation change was happening across that, they identified the pattern of that change. Then they went back, looked at everywhere else, identified similar patterns of change in vegetation, and said, okay, goats are over there. They caught them. I don't know whether they ate them or not. Okay, but anyways, so surveillance. Of course, massive amount of surveillance can be, they can achieve in cities, especially parking solutions become, parking becomes, as it becomes more problematic, where parking hotspots are coming up, where people are actually parking, and optimizing that. Second is change detection. Okay, change detection not only from a city point of view, but also from a commercial activity point of view. So where should I be putting up use cases that are coming up? Where should I be putting up supermarkets? Two, where is consumption happening of construction material? Okay, to the extent that hedge funds in America are monitoring changes on construction in China and doing hedging on cement trading. Okay, so yes, there are multiple use cases that are being, and not just from the asset owner point of view. Environment, we are talking about this. Any idea what this picture is? Anybody from Mumbai? Nope, you're from Mumbai? You know that picture? That was that, you know, the garbage dump that caught fire a couple of years back. Okay, so that's what that garbage dump did to the city. What's actually happening is, I've been showing satellites only from on land, but there are satellites that can monitor oceans. Okay, satellites that can monitor the atmospheric columns. Okay, and now satellites are being launched for greenhouse gas detection and monitoring and surveillance. So the platforms, as the platforms become smaller, more efficient, you are able to put multiple sensors. A very interesting satellite deployment that's come up is where GPS signals that are bouncing through the atmosphere are being used to map cyclones and atmospheric storms, where the storms are occurring. So that disturbance in that signal is being picked up for very detailed mapping of. So newer technologies are coming up, and they are actually coming up because of the advances that are coming, basically because of advances in AI and big data that allow you to build those models very effectively. I don't need to explain this one, right? So a couple of other things in cities, this I'm rushing, but the same application in a city in Mideast for actually identifying the biomass. We've got some recognition, so shameless marketing apologies. You know, we were actually part of the Honorable Prime Minister's delegation to Singapore. And what we are doing is mentioned in the National AI Strategy. And that's it, right? For us, the world is literally data. Thank you.